वेरी फाइन मॉर्निंग, वेरी नाइस मॉर्निंग, हाईली एनर्जेटिक मॉर्निंग, चीयरफुल चार्मिंग स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ नाइन्थ क्लास, वेलकम टू टुडे सेशन. इन अवर प्रीवियस सेशन वी वर डिस्कसिंग द फाइनल एटॉमिक मॉडल फॉर द क्लास नाइन्थ. फर्स्ट वन वाज थॉमसन मॉडल कंपेयर टू वाटरमेलॉन. ओके, सेकेंड मॉडल वाज रदरफोर्ड्स अल्फा स्कैटरिंग मॉडल वेर he discovered the nucleus, outside electrons are there. And third model was Niels Bohr, what he said, nucleus is there and around the nucleus electrons are revolving in a definite path known as orbit. So from the nucleus onwards there are different paths are there, like a ladder. Okay, so first path, second path, third path, so he named them as K element. From the nucleus, first is called as K, next is L, next is M, next is N, and so on. Okay. And in each shell, in each orbit, how many electrons are accommodated? That also you are told by using the formula 2N square. What is N here? N is the number of shell. So K shell means first shell, so N equal to 1. L is second shell, N equal to 2. M is third shell, N equal to 3. N is fourth shell, N equal to 4. Now in the K shell, where N equal to 1, how many electrons can take maximum? By using the 2n square formula, 2 into 1 square formula, because n equal to 1 here. So 2 into 1 square, it is a 2 only. And for the L, 2 into 2 square, 8. For M, 2 into 3 square, 18. And for the N, 2 into 4 square, 32, and so on. So these are the capacities of what? K element shell. So this we learnt in our yesterday's class. Now today, two more small concepts are there that will clarify. First is what? Atomic number, and the second one is what? Mass number. So once again, I welcome you all for today's session on atomic number and the mass number. Atomic number means what? Now, till now, we understood that an atom is divisible, and it is divisible into three fundamental particles: protons, electrons, and the neutrons. Protons, neutrons are present in the nucleus of an atom. Therefore, because they are present in the nucleus of an atom, therefore protons and the neutrons are called as nucleons. Okay, and outside the nucleus, electrons are there. They are revolving around the nucleus. So out of the three fundamental particles, two are in the nucleus, one is outside the nucleus. And in every atom, number of electrons and the number of protons are always equal, because electron carries minus charge, proton carries plus charge, and we know that atom is electrically neutral. So to maintain the electrical neutrality of an atom, equal number of plus and equal number of minus has to be there. Therefore, in every atom, under normal conditions, number of electrons are always equal to the number of protons. Therefore, atom is electrically neutral, and this number is called as what? Atomic number. Which number? Number of electrons which are revolving around the nucleus, or number of protons which are there inside the nucleus. This number is called as what? Atomic number. But electrons are outside, they are always busy in revolving around the nucleus. So for any property of an atom, it is electron is the most important. Therefore, electron is busy in the chemical properties or some other properties. Therefore, because electron is busy, so their number is keep changing. Sometimes electron gives, electron takes, electron shares. So due to fluctuations or change in the number of electrons, nowadays we are not taking the electron number as the atomic number. So atomic number means what? Atomic number means it is the number of protons present in the nucleus. How every boy is given roll number, every boy is given one admission number, like that. Every atom is given a number, and that number is called what? That number is the number of that atom, also known as the atomic number, which tells that how many protons are there. So by knowing the number of protons, we can tell its atomic number. In the hydrogen, only one proton is there, so atomic number of hydrogen is 1. In the oxygen, 8 protons are there, therefore atomic number of oxygen is 8. So atomic number tells us the number of protons. Okay, it also tells the number of electrons also, because both are equal. Now, what is mass number? Mass means what? Out of the three fundamental particles, proton mass is 1 AMU. What is AMU? Atomic mass unit. Unit used to express the mass of a small particles. So it is called an atomic mass unit. So it is taken as 1 AMU. So atom mass of neutron is almost equal to the mass of proton. Therefore, mass of neutron is also taken as 1 AMU. That means mass of proton is equal to the mass of neutron is equal to the 1 AMU. What about the mass of electron? It is very small. It is approximately 1/1840 times than the proton. Already atom is small. In that proton is still small. Now in proton, if you make 1840 equal parts, that smallest part is, you know, that is the mass of the electron. That means electronic mass is very, very small. So because it is very small, mass of electron is not taken into the consideration, or it is neglected, or mass of electron is negligible. Okay. So if you want to know the mass of an atom, we should know the mass of all the particles in an atom. And we know that there are three fundamental particles, proton, electron and neutron, all have mass. But out of the three, whose mass is negligible? It is the electronic mass is negligible. It is very small. Therefore, if we want to know the mass of an atom, we should know the mass of what? All protons and all neutrons add, that is the mass of that atom. So, total number of neutrons and their mass. Total number of protons and their mass. By adding these two, we get the mass of that atom. So, mass number means it is the number of P and the number of neutrons. Okay, right. Once again, I'll repeat, mass number is the number of protons and the number of neutrons. These two are where? They're in the nucleus. And these two are called as what? These two are called as what? Nucleons. So, mass number of an atom is what? Mass of its nucleons. Or mass number of an atom is what? Mass of its nucleus. Neglecting the mass of the electron. How to represent? This is the way. General way. This is the symbol of element. On the left top, we write the mass number. And left below, we write the atomic number. One example. Helium. Symbol of helium, He. Left top, its mass number. Left below, its atomic number. Same way. Okay. So in this way, we represent the mass number and the mass number for different elements or the different atoms. And this is the atomic number and the mass number of the first 20 elements on the modern periodic table, starting from hydrogen and with what? Calcium. Okay. So atomic number is the mass of, sorry, number of P or number of E, but we take it as number of P only. Mass number of P plus number of N. So mass of an atom is what? Mass of its nucleus. Okay. So kindly go through this table and you go for some other numericals or some other construct in the next session. Till then, have a nice time. Thank you and all.